Hi guys, in this video we're going to look at the changing environment of Australia and how one family of macropods, the kangaroo, has evolved because and alongside of that changing environment. We're going to talk about what the changing environment is, then look at some of the arboreal ancestors, moving to the semi-arboreal ancestors, finally the terrestrial ancestors with tree kangaroos thrown in there, and up to our modern kangaroo species. So firstly, the environment and how it changed. Basically, what happened is about 65 million years ago, Australia split from Antarctica, which was the last split away from that supercontinent of Gondwana. And since then, it's been moving northwards towards the equator. And as it's moved northwards, it's become hotter and drier, both because it's closer to the equator and because of a small ice age that occurred in that time too. So as it become hotter and drier, we've moved from the primarily rainforest landscape that once covered about 90% of Australia to the savanna, which is dominated by grass and sclerophyll, which is basically tough grass. All this stuff has happened in the Cenozoic era, so I'm going to talk about how the different epochs are in there. So it's a good idea just to have an idea about how these epochs actually relate to time in the millions of years type sense. So firstly, the arboreal ancestors, these were around in the early Miocene, which is the time when the kangaroo or macropods split from the other close ancestors they had. Now, the ancestor that they had at the time was probably similar to the ancestors of possums and similar to how possums are today. Now, I'm going to use a couple of examples here of animals that are alive today, and this is mainly so that we can imagine what these past forms of animal life are. However, I want to just stress that there weren't possums in the Miocene era. There were ancestors of possums, which were also ancestors of kangaroos, that had the characteristics of possums. So just when I'm talking about the characteristics of modern possums, just remember that we're talking about ancient possums here, which were probably similar, but don't get them confused. Okay, so the ancient ancestors of the kangaroos probably were very similar to possums. They would have lived in the trees, they're arboreal. They would have had a prehensile tail, being a tail that can actually grasp onto limbs and stuff like that. They would have had both fore and hind claws with opposable thumbs and multiple fingers for grabbing and holding onto the limbs so that they can climb the tree. And they probably moved fairly similar to other things with four legs, using a galloping motion when they run. Moving on to the late Miocene, as the rainforest thinned out, they probably needed to spend more and more time on the ground rather than in the trees. And they would have evolved so that that time on the ground is a bit better for them. So their feet and their fingers or toes would have got longer and less grabby, so that they didn't keep on getting caught on things in the ground. They would have also, at some point, lost the ability of that prehensile tail. And at this stage, rather than that galloping, they're moving in small hops. And when I say small hops, I'm not talking about how kangaroos jump at the moment. This is sort of, they move their front feet forward and then hop their back legs to that point. And this is something that probably kept around for a while. Now, the picture here I've got is of a musky rat kangaroo, which is a macropod, and it is still alive and found up in some very small parts of northern Queensland. And this is a type of macropod that split off from the main kangaroos, thinking our reds and eastern greys, fairly early on. As we got into the Pliocene and we moved from that woodland into a more arid environment with lots of grassland, the savanna, lots and lots of different species dominated that savanna. So we're talking out into the actual fields now and that grassland. Now, some of them were similar to the modern kangaroos, and we had some early megafauna arrive. Now, this picture here is of the short-faced kangaroo. Just to note here, this didn't actually come around until much later. I just didn't have a picture for these early ones, and we can get a couple of the points out here. So we have these long feet for hopping, although at this time they're probably still doing that bound thing, similar to that semi-arboreal. But a big one that's very important here is the development of foregut digestion. So that past ancestor with the possum would have had some sort of hindgut digestion, but so that you can get nutrients out of grass, which isn't very good to eat, having a foregut digestion is a huge advantage. Now, in the late Pliocene, we sort of went back into a glacial event, let's call it, and for a short period of time, rainforests increased, and some kangaroos went back to living in the trees, and some of these kangaroos still can be seen today in both northern Australia and in Papua New Guinea. So these are the tree kangaroos, which are a little bit more modern than those original arboreal kangaroos, but still around today. Once we got into the Pleistocene, we had lots of different species of macropods dominating that savanna. Now, food was plentiful at this stage, so the savanna had again spread, but because of the high rainfall, there was lots of food. This meant that megafauna started to really pop up and dominate at this time, mainly because there was so much food to support the large size of them. And this is where the modern evolution of kangaroos started. So the red kangaroos, modern evolution, probably started about 2 million years ago. By the late Pleistocene, the rapid climate change getting drier and warmer caused the decline of the megafauna. So most of those megafauna died out. As I said, those kangaroos, modern kangaroo had evolution here, but then they dropped in size quite substantially. By now, at I suppose the end of the Holocene, but let's not get into that, we have about 60 different species of macropods remaining in Australia and Papua New Guinea. They still well suited to that savanna. They have these big long legs. They jump very fast, and they have tails that aid the jumping and aid in their balance. In this video, we've looked at the changing environment in Australia and how kangaroos or macropods have evolved to deal with that change and alongside that change. We talked about their arboreal ancestor being similar to a possum, going to the semi-arboreal, both living in the trees and on the ground. The ancestor, similar to the modern musky rat kangaroo. We've talked about some of the terrestrial ancestors, and in particular, there's that megafauna that was in there. And at this time, getting that foregut digestion, which is very important. So tree kangaroos, those kangaroos that were terrestrial and then moved back into the trees. And we've talked about our modern kangaroos, which now dominate the landscape. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out.